at the same event as Suguri, a Japanese who became an Olympic skater for the United States. Her name is Rena Inoue. Rena and John, a perfect couple in the spotlight, but they had overcome serious challenges on the path to success and love. Santa Monica, USA.
Hi, I'm John Baldwin, and you're at my house today. I want to introduce you to the most important person in my life. Hi, Rena.
Yes.
How are you doing?
Good.
Partners on and off the ice. They were destined to meet. Rena was born in Japan. She skated from age 4.
I'm in love and it's a sunny day.
Rena Inoue Tomoaki Koyama.
At just 15, she was chosen as a Japanese Olympic skater. She skated again at the Lillehammer Olympics. At 22, she decided to go to the U.S. But there she faced a terrible ordeal. Lung cancer left her fighting for her life. And now, John. His parents were skate coaches. He began skating at just 2 years old. As a junior skater, he was hailed as a genius, but the glory didn't last. The end of his skating career was looming. That's when it happened. Rena had won her battle with cancer, and John and Rena became a pair.
I still wanted to skate. I just wanted to come back from all that, and I just wanted to prove myself what I can do. You know?
I didn't even know that. So you didn't skate for a year.
I had a really hard time. Like, I don't think I even had really consistent triples yet. But probably the reason you didn't know is because you were taking some time off from skating too. So we both were out of shape.
Mm-hmm.
Do you remember?
Pair skating requires both skaters to be perfectly in sync. But neither had skated for so long. They also had to overcome language and cultural barriers.
I could tell why all the American pair teams split up quickly. And I thought
that's because immediate gratification. We want it to happen right away. And if it doesn't happen right away, then we're going to quit skating.
They never admit their fault, either one of them. So they just keep on fighting on one thing, and you know, it's not me, it's you, and it's not me, it's you. But you never were that kind of person. You always paid attention on what I said, or you know, you really try to follow through what I told you to do, or you know, that kind of stuff. So like I really knew that you're a really right kind of person for me.
I also enjoyed skating with you because I had a lot of respect for you as a skater, and then eventually as a person, as I fell in love with you, you know, on the ice skating with you, I found out the kind of person you were, and it's nice to be with someone that you love on the ice and spend that much time together.
2 years after teaming up, they finished fourth in the U.S. Championships. 2 years later, they took the crown, U.S. champions. And last year, Rena made a big decision. She discarded her Japanese nationality. Getting U.S. citizenship meant they could skate in the Olympics.
I have to say it was a very difficult decision for me. You know, we came a long way, and we really put our time, effort, and also money into this, our career. And I just thought I wanted this team to get as many successes we can get. And if the Olympic is one of them, that'll be great.
Representing the United States of America, Rena
29, John 32. They took a major gamble in the ultimate arena, a technique only they could pull off.
So here we are, we have nothing to lose. All we can do is just being aggressive, show off what we can do out there. Just nothing to lose.
They succeed in an Olympic first, a throw triple axel. Their names have gone down in history.
Oh, I wanted to know one more thing. Is that okay? In that Olympic, did you think it was all worth it?
Just to have that experience of that Olympic experience, it makes all that training worth it. And then obviously you and I making history there, that definitely made everything worth it.
That's good.
What a page to add to their album of memories.
I do want to ask you this though, why don't you cook me food anymore? Why do I always do all the cooking?